The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
We ran the test work and got outstanding results. Like, we were able to remove 90% of the internal waste, and at the same time, we only lost like less than 1% of the mineralized material. So really good recovery, really good result.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Stephen Twyerould. He is the CEO of Gunnison Copper. And Stephen, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Yeah, really good, Steve. Thanks for having us on.
Yeah, well, I know that you've had some news on. We'll talk about that in just a second. But I think it's important to also address the news you had last week, because it's such a significant milestone for the company. And that is that you're producing copper now, which I know has been a long time coming, but an exciting turn.
Exciting, yeah. I mean, look, the organization's really proud of that. The whole team on site are proud of that. We've been working on that now for 12 months. It's been like a 12 months construction. So yeah, you know, like, we've just joined the ranks of the newest copper producer in the US here. Our product's going directly into the US market. So it's American made copper, pure cathode too, you know, so we're producing a product that when it goes into the market, it can be directly used for wire manufacture or pipe manufacture. So very proud of that outcome for us.
Stephen, the news that you just released was talking about breakthrough sorting results. And maybe we could take a step back and you can sort of talk about what that is and what it means and how investors should understand about that.
Yeah, those results, like, that's part of a bigger program that we call the High Value Add Program. And it's all related to our flagship asset. So Johnson Camp, that producer that I just talked about, that's kind of like 2 kilometers north of the big flagship project, which is called Gunnison. We just did a PEA on that sort of, you know, late last year, NPV, sort of 1.3 billion US dollars after tax. It's a big project. What we did from that PEA is we identified a number of programs we thought would add more value to the already sort of good looking project. One of those was mineral sorting. And it's in its simplest terms, when you mine all this material from the pit and you put it on the leach pad for processing, there's a lot of internal waste on that. You can't separate it at the scale of a really large mine. So we came up with the idea of this intermediate step between when we mine it and when we put it on the leach pad. If we can run it through a machine that basically it's an optical sensor, you know, if it's mineralized material, it can identify it optically. And if it's waste, it can identify it optically. And it just splits it into two piles, minerals, waste. Mm-hmm. So good concept, because what it would mean is that we don't have to process all of that waste that we're mining as a part of the whole mining outfit. So we took a big sample of that. We went off to our, there was a lab in Kentucky in the US here. We ran the test work and got outstanding results. Like, we were able to remove 90% of the internal waste. And at the same time, we only lost like less than 1% of the mineralized material. So really good recovery, really good result.
And it's also the amount of stuff that you're using to separate that as well drops down also, which is a positive for the project as well, as far as economics are concerned.
Yeah, actually, it really is. Like, so, you know, if you think about it, if you take sort of 40 to 50% of the material you're going to process and you don't process it, but it's got no copper in it, not only do you have a big saving on acid consumption, but it means that your head grade that you're processing goes up. Like, I take out 50%, it's got no copper. That means the 50% that's left, it's got twice the copper grade. So our head grade goes up, our costs go down because we're not, you know, consuming the acid on this waste. It means our leach pad is smaller, so we can have lower capital costs. So yeah, it's a good outcome all around.
Yeah, Stephen, is this a good example of a project the size that you're talking about of Gunnison, the ability to find these little sort of bits of savings here or there that can really de-risk a project in general and just bring the economics into a more favorable light for really any project that you're doing?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I mean, the project's already got good economics, right? Yeah. I mean, internal rate of returns, 21%. NPV, as I mentioned, you know, was like 1.3 billion US. Like, I think our sort of all-in sustaining cash cost is about $1.94 per ton, per pound, sorry. So it's already a good project. What tends to happen is as you go through the pre-feasibility and the feasibility stage, and you go through that de-risking process, costs go up, recoveries go down, certain things can happen. So we're looking at ways that we can counter that before we even go through the pre-feasibility study. You know, this is one of them where, you know, we can lower costs, operating costs, and we can increase the head grade. That information will feed into an updated study.
Well, exciting times ahead for sure. And little things make the big difference. That's for sure, Stephen. Thank you so much. Good to get an update on this latest news. And we look forward to our next conversation. Okay.
Oh, for sure. More news coming.
All right. We look forward to that. That's Stephen Twyerould. He is the CEO of Gunnison Copper.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.